Sound speeds, which makes it so much fun to control, especially for those of us that need quiet recording environments, like people with home studios, or people trying to set up a call center, or people that just want to have a quiet reading room. But if you start looking online, you're going to run into two terms, soundproofing and sound deadening. But what's the difference? Simply put, soundproofing is trying to prevent sound from going in and out of a particular place. Sound deadening, on the other hand, is going to prevent the sounds within the space from echoing amongst each other. For example, if I'm really, really loud, my voice, if it did not have this acoustic foam on the side, would bounce all within this space and I would hear myself echoing within the room. If it's just soundproofed, that's not going to do anything for those waves within the room created by me. But sound deadening will help to tone those down a little bit. Sometimes it's referred to as sound absorbing. I always refer to it as sound deadening, but either one is a correct term. So if you're looking into soundproofing, the things you want to keep in mind are thickness and density. You want to have a dense surface, something like multiple layers of wood, maybe some rubber in there, some very dense materials to actually jam into the walls and prevent the sound from coming through there, because, you know, sound is basically vibration and it's going to travel through pockets of air nicely, but if it's very, very dense, it's going to have more of a difficult time getting through those. Sound deadening or absorbing is the exact opposite. It's a very soft material that's going to prevent the echoes from traveling around. So between the two of those, soundproofing and sound deadening slash absorbing, you're going to make yourself a very quiet room. Orfield Labs in Minneapolis, Minnesota has created what many places refer to as the world's quietest room. And the way they did this is by using a lot of soundproofing to make this room extremely quiet. And then all around in 360 around, the person who's in there is a lot of sound deadening material. So any and all sounds are completely blocked from every single possible angle. So let's talk about two different examples where you might run into a need for soundproofing or sound deadening. The first one let's look at is going to be recording wild lines for a film, and the second is a home studio environment. So let's just say you're on location, or you're even on the soundstage. You're going to look for certain things like brick or cinder blocks, something that you can think of that would block sound very nicely, because people on set are going to most likely be quiet, and if they're not holding the work, you got to make sure you're far away from that. By putting as many layers of dense material between you and the noise sources, that is going to make it as quiet as possible. If you're trying to then make that environment quieter, you can use something like furniture pads, or you can use acoustic foam that you may keep on your sound trailer. Something like that, even if it is light and just takes out some echoes, your room is already pretty absorbent to sound, you're just going to try to take out some of the standing waves. Here's another little bit of information about that. You don't need them on all four corners and the ceiling and the floor. Ideally, you would have carpet on the floor, so that would take out quite a bit of it. And if you can get something above you, even better. But as long as you have carpet on the ground, that should take out any of the big reflections between the ceiling and the floor. However, on the walls is another story. You don't want to necessarily have it on all four corners of your wall. You could get away with it just fine with on this wall and this wall, or this wall and that wall. Two that are in a right angle. You don't need them like this. Those standing waves are being taken care of. You want them on a right angle so that the waves going between two walls like this, one would absorb, the other one would reflect, and between the two of them, your sound's not going to go very far. If you're setting up a home studio, on the other hand, you have all the time in the world to get things set up properly. As a matter of fact, as long as you don't have a deadline for any recording that you have to do, your timeline is basically infinite, and so you can spend as much time as you want setting it up. Now, here's what you want to try to use if you are setting up a home studio. Think styrofoam. Think dense foam. Think acoustic fiberglass insulation. Things like that are really what you want to try to use to set up your home studio. Now, there's all kinds of wonderful tutorials online for creating your own acoustic foam pads and baffles and everything like that. Well, let's just look at one product there is out there. Acoustic insulation by Owens Corning, and it's specifically Owens Corning 703. You can get it in three different varieties: 4-inch thick, 2-inch thick, 1-inch thick. And the difference is, Well, the thicker, obviously, the better, right? Well, if you can't afford it, think about it this way. About $120 is going to get you 3 pieces of the 4-inch, or it's going to get you 6 pieces of the 2-inch, or it's going to get you 12 pieces of the 1-inch. Basically, you're paying about $120 for 12 inches of thickness. And that thickness you can use all over the place. You may say for your money, I can only really afford the 2-inch because I need to cover quite a bit. Great, do what you can. If you can only afford 1-inch, it will still do quite a bit. So if price is no object, you want to go for the 4-inch version. The 4-inch version is going to be much better for the lower frequencies.
Like people with deep voices.
Not like me. And the people that play like the bass or the bass guitar, things that have very low frequencies and you want to make sure it absorbs it. Well, what if there's a door and or windows that you need to keep open when you're not recording? Well, here's a quick solution for that. Get yourself a piece of hopefully dense wood, put your acoustic deadening material on that, and then lean it up against the wall when you're not using it, and then put it over the windows or the doors when you are recording. Now, let's just say you have something like maybe a computer and you want to make a sound baffle between them. One thing you can do is either make yourself or buy yourself an acoustic panel, let's say maybe 2 feet by 3 feet wide for just example, and get yourself a television mounting stand. Maybe a freestanding one on Amazon would be $50-$60. And then you can screw that panel directly onto that television stand, and then you can move it wherever you need to. So there you have it. The basics on soundproofing and sound deadening, whether you're on location or in your own private recording environment. If you'd like additional information, there's a couple of links down there in the description. But in the meantime, I will see you in the next video where we will give you some more sound advice.
Have a question you'd like answered or want to add something? Be sure to write it in the comment section down below. You can also make a suggestion for future topics of discussion. Again, comment section down below, or you can email me at soundspeeds@yahoo.com. Be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss out on future sound advice.